Let's say that we have the sum 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1, and it just keeps going on and on and on like that forever. And we can write that with sigma notation. This would be the sum from n is equal to 1, lowercase n equals 1, to infinity. We have an infinite number of terms here of, let's see, this first one we want it to be a positive 1, and then we want to keep switching terms. So we could say this is negative 1 to the lowercase n minus 1 power. Let's just verify that that works. When n is equal to 1, it's negative 1 to the 0 power, which is that. When n is equal to 2, it's 2 minus 1, it's negative 1 to the first power, that's equal to that right over there. So this is a way of writing this series. Now what I want to think about is, does this series converge to an actual finite value? And this is another way of saying it, it's like, what is this sum? Is there a finite sum that we can say is equal to this right over here? Or does this series diverge? And the way that we can think about that is by thinking about its partial sums. Let me write that down. The partial sums of this series. And the way we could define the partial sums, so we'll give an index here, so capital N. So the partial sum is going to be the sum from N equals 1, but not infinity, but to capital N of negative 1 to the n minus 1. So just to be clear what this means, so the partial sum with just one term is just going to be from n, lowercase n equals 1 to uppercase n equals 1. So it's just going to be this first term right over here. It's just going to be 1. The s sub 2 is going to be equal to 1 minus 1. It's going to be the sum of the first two terms. S sub 3 is going to be 1 minus 1 plus 1. It's the sum of the first three terms, which is, of course, equal to, let's see, this is equal to 1. This one over here is equal to 0. S sub 4 is going to be 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0 again. So once again, the question is, does this sum converge to some finite value? And I encourage you to pause this video and think about it, given what we see about the partial sums right over here. So in order for a series to converge, that means that the limit, an infinite series to converge, that means that the limit, so if your convergence is the same thing as saying that the limit as capital N approaches infinity of our partial sums is equal to some finite, let me just write like this, is equal to some finite value. So what is this limit going to be? Well, let's see if we can write this. So this is going to be, let's see, S sub N, if we wanted to write it in general terms, we already see if capital N is odd, it's equal to 1. If capital N is even, it's equal to 0. So we could write, let's write this down. So S sub N, I could write it like this. It's going to be 1 if N odd. It's equal to 0 if N even. So what's the limit as S sub N approaches infinity? So what's the limit? What's the limit as n approaches infinity of s sub n? Well, this limit doesn't exist. It keeps oscillating between these points. You give me, you go one more, it goes from 1 to 0. You give me one more, it goes from 0 to 1. So it actually is not approaching a finite value. So this right over here does not exist. Does not exist. It's tempting because it's bounded. It keeps oscillating between 1 and 0, but it does not go to one particular value as n approaches infinity. So here we would say that our series S diverges. Our series S diverges.